PRP for hair treatment. I am a 29-year-old female with androgenic alopecia. I am a 29-year-old female with androgenic alopecia. Is PRP real or a waste of money?
Thank you for your question. You're a 29-year-old female with androgenetic alopecia, and you're asking, is PRP real or a waste of money? Well, I'll give you a little bit of background. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon. I've been performing hair transplant for many years. I'm in practice for over 20 years. And I do use PRP a lot in my practice. And I've developed a treatment that is PRP-based, or I should say PRP is part of that treatment, called hair regeneration. Now, if you're saying you have androgenetic alopecia, I would work under the assumption that you had a biopsy confirming this, as opposed to just clinical examination, because it's unusual for a younger woman to have androgenetic alopecia. Now, as far as PRP for female pattern hair loss, I would say that PRP is not effective on its own. PRP can cause short-term growth, and we've observed that for years. We've been using PRP before we developed hair regeneration to help assist growth. We've been using PRP in all other areas of the body. We use it on the face, we use it under the eyes for wrinkles, for dark circles, for pigmentation. It's very, very useful. But for hair thinning, and that's what androgenetic alopecia is, I would not say PRP is that effective. In fact, we have patients who come to us who had PRP done for their scalp for hair loss, and basically they were going in for monthly treatments of PRP injections, and they weren't seeing dramatic improvement. They weren't seeing any improvement. And so what we do is something very different. We combine PRP with acellular matrix, and we termed this hair regeneration. In fact, we've started a company called Trichostem Hair Regeneration with the mission of bringing this technology closer to people. We have patients who come from all over the world for this treatment. Now, this treatment for male pattern hair loss comes close to almost 100% success rate in terms of a verifiable, measurable improvement in the hair thinning, in terms of reversal and thickening of hair. More than 80% of female pattern hair loss, we see improvement. So I think that your question about PRP is that, unfortunately, up to a point, and this is what we're doing is very much fairly ahead of the curve, because the gold standards of treatment of hair loss has always been medications, and for women it was basically just minoxidil. For men it was finasteride and minoxidil. And then there was transplantation. There was nothing in the middle. So hair regeneration, what we've developed, has turned out to be quite an impressive tool to help people. And when we do this treatment, we do one injection. We'll follow our patients every 3 months to observe the regrowth, and for most women it takes about 9 to 12 months to see an improvement. Then it has to do with things to do with the physiology of hair growth. But we watch our patients very, very closely, and we follow our patients for up to 18 months. There are some patients we'll even do a second injection on, so we've been able to establish that this treatment can actually build upon. So it's very exciting. It's an exciting time. So again, to answer your question, you've already heard that I think there is limited value. I wouldn't say it's a waste, but I think it's limited value, PRP alone. But in the context of what we do with hair regeneration, it's been quite impressive. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.